24-year-old male patient presented with right-handed weakness, MRI, T2-weighted imaging showing a bubbly lesion with peripheral hemosiderin rim in the left corner radiata, which is extending up to the cortex. You can see lesions in the thalamus, bilateral temporal lobes, and also in the brainstem. These lesions we have diagnosed as cavernomas. So cavernomas or cavernous hemangiomas are nothing but a venous malformation or a hamartomas lesion, which are angiographically inactive or they won't be seen. They are occult on angiogram. They won't show any contrast enhancement. So these lesions, they have been classified by Jabrowski into four types. There are four types of cavernomas. Type 2 is the classical popcorn type, and type 4 is relatively very difficult to diagnose because it presents as microhemorrhages, and lot of differentials can be considered for that type of microhemorrhage type of type 4. When there are recurrent hemorrhages, the lesions will grow in size. They can have vasogenic edema. There is a this is susceptible to weighted images. You can see this could be a case of familial cavernoma syndrome, where there are mixed type 2 and type 4 of cavernomas in this case. However, it should be proven with genetical analysis, which we have not done. And again, we should also prove in one more patient from same family. Cavernomas can be associated with developmental venous anomalies or venous angiomas. Whenever you find a cavernoma, you search for venous angioma. Cavernous angiomas are hamartomas lesions which don't have any normal interspersed brain parenchyma. They're just blood filled spaces. They don't have muscle fibers, so they can't be called as normal veins. So they are angiographical occult. These cavernous angiomas can be called as cavernous hemangioma, cerebral cavernous venous malformations. Epidemiology is like 90% occur sporadic cases and 10% occur in familial cases. Familial cases occur due to CRIT gene mutation. Familial and brainstem cavernomas bleed more often than the regular sporadic ones. Seizures is the most common presentation. Most of them can be asymptomatic. Sometimes they can present with hemichorea, hiccups and dysphagia, sensory disturbances, other rare presentations of cavernomas. Jabrowski has calcified cavernomas based on their T1 and T2 appearance. Type 1 is nothing but it mimics subacute hemorrhage, which is hyperintense on T1 and hypointense on T2. Type 2 is the classical popcorn ball type, which has mixed signal intensity in both T1 and T2. Type 3 is chronic hemorrhage type, and type 4 is punctate microhemorrhages, which was earlier described on T2. Now with our advanced imaging, now it is extended to GRE and susceptible to weighted images. It is the most challenging type to diagnose because there are multiple differentials to this condition. Whenever you see a cavernoma, if it is asymptomatic, you should leave them. If at all they are symptomatic, surgery can be advised. So that is about cavernomas. We will be showing some cavernomas which we have seen. This is right corner radiata, popcorn type of calcifications, cavernoma on CT scan. This is the right caudate nucleus cavernoma, which this patient presented with hemichorea. So they can, based on the location, they can have different types of presentations. Then this was an incidental cavernoma of temporal lobe. This was a pontine cavernoma. You could see there were repeated stages of bleed in case of cavernoma. And this is a left midbrain cavernoma. You can see the repeated hemorrhages. Brainstem cavernomas often bleed compared to the other ones. This is medullary cavernoma. This patient had a very mild symptoms or hemihypesthesia. So this is about cavernomas. Thank you very much. Hope it was useful.